Welcome back, Word Warriors. This is day 75. I'm Melissa at Safe Haven Ministries. And today we're going to talk about setting boundaries. How many of you have trouble saying no? I mean, you mean to say no, but yes falls out your mouth every time you start to form the word no. In the physical world, boundaries are everywhere. They're easy to see. Fences, signs, wells, moats with alligators in them, hedges. And we know that that sends the message that says, this is my property. I'm responsible for what happens on my property. That's your property over there, but this is my property. I'm not responsible for your property. But here's the thing. How many of you are crossing into somebody else's territory and taking care of them? You know, maybe I'm talking about the kids don't have to get a job because you keep supplying them money. Or maybe they don't have to take care of their kids because you're raising their kids. Or maybe they don't want to do something, anything, and you always step in and take care of them. Physical boundaries mark a visible property line. And that holds people responsible. And they say, you know, I've got to stay off that. That doesn't belong to me. Well, in the spirit realm, they're harder to see, but they're there. In Proverbs 4:23, it says, guard your heart above all else, for it determines the course of your life. Why does Solomon say, guard your heart? Well, the reason for that is because that's our thought life, it's our inner man, our emotions, and if we don't guard it, we're going to let people run our lives for us. I know some of you know what I'm talking about. If you know and understand what belongs to you and what you're responsible for, there's freedom that comes with that. God created this world so that we can live within ourselves. We inhabit our own souls, and we're responsible for the things inside us. Proverbs 4:10 says, each heart knows its own bitterness, and no one else can fully share its joy. I want you to look at two scriptures today. The first scripture is found in Galatians 6:2, and it says this, carry each other's burdens, and in that way, obey the law of Christ. Carry each other's burdens, and that's obeying the law of Christ. In the Greek, the word burden is an interesting word. It's a word that means the weight that's on you from these burdens that you carry is so great, it's like a rock that's crushing you. Normally, this type of thing comes when you face a tragedy. You go through a crisis, a loss of a child, a loss of a spouse, but it's something that is just devastating to you. And in that case, it says we need to come alongside these people because they need someone with them. And basically what it means is they don't have the strength, the resources, or the knowledge to carry themselves through this situation. But there's another word that looks like it's just the opposite. It's found in Galatians 6:5, and it says, each one should carry their own load. Well, notice we're supposed to carry somebody else's burdens, but we're supposed to carry our own load. What does that mean? Well, the word load means cargo, or the burden of daily toil or daily life. That word describes everyday things that we do every day of our lives. Nobody needs to come in and take care of that for you. That's what it's saying. You do what you need to do to take care of yourself on a daily basis. That's your responsibility. But it's our responsibility as Christians to step in if the burden is too heavy for someone to carry. And that comes, like I say, from a tragedy or a crisis. We don't want to get these two mixed up. If somebody is trying to carry a burden all by themselves and they're refusing help and saying, I don't need you. I don't need anybody else. And God's word is saying that weight is too much. Pride is what gets in the way. And we're too prideful to let somebody step in and help. That's when you're kind of out of line there. Here's another one. When somebody else is trying to get you to carry their daily load, they don't want to do it. They don't want to accept responsibility for it. You know, I don't want to cook something. You cook it for me. I don't have any money. Why do you not have money? Because I spent it all. I need to borrow $50. I'm telling you, you can wear yourself out doing that. Now, here's an example let's go a little bit further with boundaries. Boundaries keep the good stuff in and the bad stuff out. That's what it does. They guard our treasures so people can't steal from us. And you're thinking, what do they want to steal from me? I haven't got anything worth anything. Yes, you do. I'm talking about stealing your peace, your joy, your laughter, your strength, material things. Boundaries are not walls. Boundaries are not walls. The Bible says we're to be walled off. Does not say we're to be walled off from others. What it says is our walls have to be flexible so people can come in and go out. Only the good comes in, the bad goes out. The idea of boundaries comes from God. He's the one that set boundaries. Do you know that God has limits on who he'll let play in his yard? Oh, yeah. If you're full of sin and you're wanting to get closer to God, it's not going to happen. Not till you repent of sin, because he won't let that sin get near him. He's got boundaries. He guards his house and will not allow evil things to go on there. He invites people in who will love him, and he lets his love flow out towards them. The gates of his boundaries open and close appropriately. Ours don't always do that. Sometimes we let in things we shouldn't be letting in. Like drama mamas, they don't have any place in our life. No, no, no. God gave us personal responsibilities within the limits. He wants us to be stewards of the things that he's given us. Genesis 1:26 says this, "Then God said, let us make mankind in our image, in our likeness, so they may rule over the fish of the sea and the birds in the air, and over the livestock and all the wild animals and over all the creatures that move on the ground." Here's a couple of boundaries you probably never thought of. Your skin is a boundary. It's a boundary. It keeps the good in and the bad out. It protects your blood, your bones, holds everything together on the inside. If you didn't have skin, you'd be looking kind of funny right now. It keeps germs on the outside, so you're protected from infection. Do you know that your skin is so important? But do you know that when someone is sexually abused and someone invades their space and touch their body, they have trouble from that point on establishing their own boundaries in life? Words are a boundary. You know what the one word is, best boundary setting word there is? Two letters. No. No. It lets others know that you have a will and you want to do it your way. You're in control of your life. Being clear about your no and your yes is a theme that we even see in the Bible. In Matthew 5:37, it says, "But let your yes be yes and your no be no." Now, we're going to stop there today, but we're going to finish some more on boundaries tomorrow. So you need to be here. Yes, sir. Father, 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 in the name of Jesus, I thank you for these people. Today, some of them are heading out to work, Lord, and they're going to be so busy. And I just pray that you make this day go smoothly, but you interrupt them when it's something that you want done. And at the end of the day, they can turn around and go, "That was God. That was a God moment." Lord, give us God moments all day today. We just thank you and praise you and help us to set boundaries and practice the word no. No. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. I will see you tomorrow morning. God bless.